In Somali, we call it wakamira.
Ha, wakamira.
Wakamira. Martes, awadi dafit suwahdi uswa kamira aso arkesa. Kurun da gilnesa ready to go.
Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
In this Saudi Dah, I'm Hani. Welcome back to another video. Thank you for joining us. Kusoo dawada another video today. I just went grocery shopping. Aftah didn't really go with me. I don't know why he's sitting here, but he's just keeping me company, I guess.
I'm acting like I'm going to shop with you.
Yeah, I went to one of my favorite grocery stores, which is Trader Joe's. And I just want to show you guys what I got. I was supposed to film at this grocery store, but everybody was staring at me, and I'm like, no, thank you. So I'm just going to show you a couple of the things we got.
Can we eat while we recording?
Some of these things are not ready for... Okay, so I'm gonna show you a lot of the snacks that we get. This Amelia loves this string cheese. Everything, by the way, everything we buy for our household is organic. So we have this string cheese organic snacking. I put this in their snack boxes. They usually snack on it when they're here. There's about two people that only eat that in our household, and that's Amelia and Ali. Ali, Amir, and Ahmed don't really eat anything that's unhealthy. And for yogurt choices, here you can just show them. For yogurt choices, I get this also from Trader Joe's. It's their Trader Joe's brand. I get the vanilla and blueberry. You can find in their store. It's not quite organic, which is kind of like, I usually never get anything that's organic, but I love this yogurt, and it's Trader Joe's brand, so
you can't go wrong with that. You know what I'm saying?
Sometimes you can't find everything you want that's organic, you know what I mean? This one is the peach and mango. You can also find this at Trader Joe's. It's under their dairy. I usually just like to grab like little fruits. I wish I was the kind of person that actually cuts up fruits, you know. I'm not that kind of mom. I like the ones that are already cut up and ready, and the kids can just snack on it, and that can just snack on it. I can just snack on it, and I can ensure that my kids eat fruits. Cause I mean, we're kind of like on the go, very busy, so I don't really have time to like cut fruits and make it cute. So basically, you guys, the way I used to shop was just get whatever my mind. And I would just like overspend, overshop. Pack my fridge with things that we may not even get to that will go bad. So when I started going to Trader Joe's, I started really saving up more money, getting small portions. Cause I mean, I go shopping probably twice a week. So why not? So I'm gonna show you a couple other snacks. This is a peanut butter pencil snack. It has peanut butter inside of it. I got the not salty one for health because I'm always about keeping the kids healthy. So the kids love this. This is like a quick school snack that you guys, if you're looking for a quick school snack, this is yummy. And if your little one likes peanut butter and they like pencils, yum.
So this is called Sampel Brino.
And it's the bloody orange one. I love it, the kids love it. I usually get that once a week just for like a treat, kind of like a dinner on the side, because we only drink water when we're home. Except for that once a week when I do get that. Or there's another time when I do get lemonade too, so that's like twice a week actually. I mean, you know, the thing is I'm like really strict, but not really strict. Does that make sense? You guys, wait for it. I have the most exciting one. You guys, wait for it. This,
it's a
you
lifesaver.
Will love me. You will love me,
This
okay?
is a lifesaver.
This is a weekend brunch idea that I do with my family. It's a croissant. It's a chocolate croissant only found at Trader Joe's. I'm lying. I don't know if it's found somewhere else, but I find this at Trader Joe's. I think it's their own brand. It's a chocolate chip croissant. You leave it out overnight for 8 hours. It puffs up, and then up you just put it in the
Somali
oven.
You know, in Somali,
we call it
wakamira. Ah, wakamira. Wakamira. But this, how did that fit? So, wakamira, so, arkeza. Form the gillets are ready to go.
And then the thing is, it smells like you actually been baking for hours when all you did was forno dal gilla. Aftah forno dal gilla. Aftah just pops it in there before.
What are you
wake
trying
up.
To say? I don't know how to do. I don't know how to cook.
I'm gonna have to show you guys a video where we actually make this and eat it. It's so yummy. It's like fresh chocolate croissants, like homemade without you actually making it.
You know, honey tricked me the first time. I thought I was like, damn, honey, do you know how to make this? She was like, yeah, I made this. Yeah. I then come to find out the box was, she forgot the box on the counter.
I actually still do that to a lot of people. When people are saying, I'm gonna come over for brunch or breakfast, I just kind of like make this and pretend like, oh, let me just grab this from the oven. So if you're trying to impress someone but you don't really feel like cooking, this is it.
This is a savior.
I usually get small tomatoes like this, two or three, because I'm thinking about already dra bilash arawana creo this weekend. So this is my dra bilash nyanyo.
Can I get one of those?
No, this is for Amir and Ahmed. I basically got them this. It's a treat that I get to reward them for the things they do right. And this is basically a vanilla with cooking crust. It's just, it sounds good. I think it comes in how many pieces? Oh, there's 12 pieces. So there's enough for everybody in the family. Yes.
Two for each to be exact.
Yes, I do use frozen veggies because they're just easy and it keeps them fresh. But don't worry about them. They're organic, okay? Check this out. Organic frozen veggies. And you have all your veggies here. You have beets, you have carrots, you have green beans, you have corn. I love broccoli, but I'm like the only one in this family that loves broccoli.
Don't forget the banana.
So I can just add a dash, because when they see a lot of broccoli, none of my kids will eat. So I basically just add like a little dash into my spaghetti or my bris or my madak, whatever I'm making, or my veggies, whatever I'm making. And I like to get a small one because I don't like when things go bad. This is probably gonna last me a week, you guys. And like Aftah said, organic.
Every Somali person needs to have a banana in the house.
And I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Perfect!
Have you guys noticed something? Hani already pre-calculated every single thing that we're gonna eat for the week, right? Or for
That's
a couple
how you
days.
Save money when it goes to, because we used to be the kind of people that would just go grocery shopping and just get whatever, and just we'll just get excessive amount that we didn't use or eat, and they'll go bad, and then we'll have to throw it away and then spend more money. But now everything is calculated. We eat good. We're eating somewhat fresh because, I mean, I do have to put some of this stuff in the fridge. And today I got something different. I haven't tried this before. Pure mango ice cream.
Them.
What is this? How do you say this in Somali?
Anap.
Just the other day someone asked me, I'm so happy that you're teaching your kids the Somali tradition, even though your husband is Hindi.
Allahu Akbar. Shekel bin Wadan.
Shekel bin Wadan. Come on, you can't Somali. Joji wa has, okay? Anap Kuruna. Oh my god, you guys. This is, I have been obsessed with this. This is a broccoli snack. If you know it, you know it. If you hate it, then forget you, okay? My kids hate it. My kids hate my breath after I eat it. My husband probably hates it. But it's so yummy and I've been obsessed with it. I usually get obsessed with like a certain snack every now and then. This is my latest obsession, is dry broccoli. And it has a little bit of Parmesan cheese. It looks like, I don't know if they fried it or they just put it in the oven, but it is so good, you guys. It's like $2.99 a pack. It's the best snack if you're trying to be healthy because it gives you that crunchy feeling like you're eating chips, but you're actually eating broccoli.
So just as if we didn't have enough banana, we also have to get a dry banana. What do you say about that one?
Yeah, they're called the plantain chips, which is basically dry banana. It has just a minimum salt. I think this is the Trader Joe's version. I mean, they have it everywhere, so you can find it. My kids like this one because it has like a little bit of a sour to it. It tastes like chips. If you don't know that you're eating banana, it tastes like chips, but they're eating banana.
That's why they call it plantain chips.
Yeah, and it's so healthy, you guys. For kids, this is like their school snack, their home snack, their everyday snack. Check it out. Everything this is what I usually use for my quesadillas. It's healthy, easy to make quesadillas for lunch. I got this grocery for Ahmed because he loves it. And another thing is, you can be really healthy because otherwise you're just gonna go to 7-Eleven and try to buy chips. And if you follow me on Instagram, then you know I like to make that one pot pasta that I'm obsessed with lately. But this is my secret sauce. Found at Trader Joe's for my one pot pasta. It makes it really creamy. I combine this two to make my pastas, but only when I'm making the one pot pasta, which I have to show you guys on here. It has been a life-saving. Oh my god, this popcorn is amazing. If you don't buy this popcorn for your kids, I don't know what you're doing with yourself. 50% less fat. It tastes like it has 50% more fat. Honestly, it's so tasty. It's a kettle corn and it has a little bit of sweet and sour to it. It's almost like and mix it up and put it in a popcorn and it's amazing. I just want to tell you something, okay? All the cereals in America are trying to kill us.
Oh yeah, I heard about that one.
You want to get a simple cereal with simple ingredients. Like, I mean, I don't mind getting, I don't care, like cinnamon square. I'm not a fan of cinnamon square. My kids love it. But at least I know that when they eat this in the morning, I know that they're not eating poison, because a lot of the cereals basically are poisoning your children and yourself. So this one literally has a very simple ingredient. You look at how tiny the ingredient box is. And it's like things that you can pronounce that you know what they are.
As a matter of fact, do your research for every single thing you put in your mouth.
Oh, it's yummy. Thank you for joining us and thank you for listening to our grocery week. A lot of people ask me what's on your fridge, so this is what's going in my fridge today.